The Ramayan Simon Aleph in Halacha Aleph says, "Gam behesnei lachet ubishkavo al mishkavo yoda lefne mihu shochev." The Ramah says that a person should walk humbly with Hashem, and also when a person goes to sleep, he should know before whom he is laying down. And immediately when a person wakes up in the morning, he should get up with quickness to be able to serve Hashem, his Creator, may He be blessed. The Mishnah Berurah doesn't understand why does the Shulchan Aruch have to tell us that a person needs to walk modestly with Hashem. We know, by the way, that this is one of the most fundamental rules in the Torah, that a person always must with Hashem, and he should not seek out into the future what's going to happen, what happened, except all these things. A person has to walk wholeheartedly with HaKadosh Baruch Hu and not ask any questions. So what is the Ramah telling us? So the Mishnah Berurah tells us in Sivkat and Zayin, when the Ramah says, Gam behesnei lachet, when the Ramah says that you should walk modestly with Hashem, the Mishnah Berurah tells you what's the Kavanah, what's the intention behind the Ramah. He says, Rotel Omar, he wants to say, Av b'sha'ah shehu b'beito b'hesne'ah, gam ken yei lechto im Hashem Elohav. Even when a person is in his own house, when he's closed off in his own house, modestly he is by himself over there, nevertheless, the Mishnah Berurah tells you, you also have to walk with Hashem your God. It's not like outside I have a black hat and I look religious, but inside I act like any way I want. It doesn't work like that. The Mishnah Berurah tells you that, in a way, if I can try to put it in a better language, Hashem is like your shadow. So if you think that Hashem is not seeing you, he doesn't know what you're doing, on the contrary, he does. He's literally just like your shadow, goes with you everywhere. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he also goes with you everywhere. So don't think just outside or in shul or while you're learning Torah, in the study halls, only there is Hashem. But when you come home, Hashem is not there. No, chas v'shalom. On the contrary, a person from there, you'll see how much Yerusha mind a person has. How much fear of Hashem does he have? Not the way people act in front of other people, trying to put on a show that they're religious Jews. On the contrary, what do you do inside the house? And who's going to be able to testify? Your wife, your children. They know how the Abba and how the Ima behave in the house. So that's why, guys, when you are in the house, you should also present yourself like Jews and always walk modestly with Hashem, your God, even in the house, even when you're by yourself. Nevertheless, you should always remember that Kadosh Baruch Hu is watching you, like we learned in the previous Shi'urim. Now, the next piece where the Ramah says that immediately when you wake up, you have to get up with quickness, there's a very, very big problem with that, because we know that in Masechet Gittin, Daf Ayin Amud Aleph, it brings down that if a person, he gets up very quick from his sleep. For example, a person opens his eyes and then he gets up right away on his feet. He is more closer to death at that moment than to life. So therefore, a person has to be very, very careful when he wakes up in the morning. So that's what we're going to see. The Mishnah Berurah, he's going to try to explain this to Ramah. When the Ramah tells you miyad, what means miyad? You're going to wake up, the Mishnah Berurah is going to continue to say, it's good to say right away after you wake up, modeh ani lefanecha, melech chai v'kayam, shehechazavti b'nishmati, bechemla, rabba emunotecha. And between the word bechemla to rabba emunotecha, you're going to make a pause. So it's going to sound like this, modeh ani lefanecha, melech chai v'kayam, shehechazavti b'nishmati bechemla, pause, rabba emunotecha. That's how it's going to sound. And if you pay close attention, you have, I believe, 12 words in modeh ani. Let's try to see if we can count it. Modeh ani lefanecha melech chai v'kayam, shehechazarte b'nishmati bechemla rabba emunotecha. 12 words, you wait 12 seconds. By the time you finish saying that, you know you can actually get up out of bed right away. So this is what the Mishnah Berurah wants to tell us. The Mishnah Berurah wants to say, when the Ramah tells you have to get up quickly, lav davka, not necessarily. Don't get up very fast. Why? Eli yishem me'at v'lo yamot piton ki ze mazik laguf. Because the Mishnah Berurah tells us that if a person is going to get up right away, he's actually going to damage his body. So rather, what should he do? He should actually wait a little bit in bed before he gets up. Guys, the Mishnah Berurah brings down the Masechet Gittin in Daf Ayin Amud Aleph that these things can damage your body. I would like to share with you three things that can weaken your body, three things that can break your body, five things that can actually damage your body, meaning to say that you are closer to death at the time when you are doing it than to life. So Masechet Gittin in Daf Ayin Amud Aleph says like this. Shalosha Devarim. He says like there's three things. Matizin Gufo Shel Adam. There are three things that are able to weaken a person. One second, guys. Not Matizim, that's the next one. Shalosha Devarim Machichim Kucho Shel Adam. There are three things that are able to weaken a person. Ve'eluhem, and what are the three things? Pachad. Number one of them is pachad, derech, traveling, ve'avon, and sin. If a person has fear, and by the way, it's brought down the Shulchan Aruch, I believe in Siman Dalet, it's brought down that if a person, if you make your hands impure and you do not wash your hands after that, you will have fear for certain days. Sometimes it's 7 days, sometimes it's 3 days, sometimes it's 1 day. Be'ezrat Hashem b'lenet, when we will get to these halachot, we will try to see it inside. But this is what he wants to tell you over here. That a person who has fear, pachad, fear weakens a person's body. He doesn't have the same strength to continue to live life to the fullest. That's number one. Number two, traveling. When a person travels back and forth, say, whenever you are traveling, that also actually weakens a person's body. And sin, definitely, not only does it weaken you, the Gemara says it weakens you, but the damage that you do to your body, you have no idea. So therefore, a person has to be very careful with these three things. Those were three things that actually weakened a person's body. The next three things he says over here that actually break your body, Shalosha Devarim Matizin Gufo Shel Adam, three things that break a person's body, Ve'eluhen, and they are, Achal Mu'umad, V'shatam Mu'umad, V'shimesh Mitatom Mu'umad. If a person ate while he was standing, or if a person drank while he was standing, or if a person had relations with his wife while he was standing, these three things can actually break a person's body. So a person also has to be careful in all of these three things. Five things that are closer to death than to life. Chamisha kiruvim limita yoter min hachayim. Five things are closer to death than to life. Ve'eluhen, and they are, achal ve'amad. If a person, he ate, and then he got up right away, he should know at that moment, he is much closer to death than to life. Shata ve'amad. If a person drank and he got up, chizik dam ve'amad. If a person gave blood and then he got up, yashan ve'amad. And this is the one that Mr. Brew wanted to bring down, that when you're sleeping, and you're going to get up right away, you are closer to death than to life. That's why the Mishnah tells you, you should wait a little bit. That's why by the time you finish saying Modani, you're good to get up. Shemesh mitato ve'amad, or if a person had relations with his wife and he got up right away, again guys, you are closer to death than to life, chas v'shalom. So people have to be careful with these things when they are doing it. Now I'll tell you a secret, there's a beautiful behetav in Chalik Bet in the Mishnah Berurah. He brings down over there a beautiful pshat on how and to what reason were the brachot instituted. For example, Borei Nefashot or Al Hamichia or Birkat Hamazon, meaning the after blessings after why we eat. So they say like this, guys, when a person, let's say a person wants to have 3 ounces of water, for example, he drinks 3 ounces in one shot, he's obligated in the bracha of Borei Nefashot. So what's the chiddush, what's the novelty over here? Very simple. Because he says like this, that what was the whole reason why they instituted? Of course you have to give a blessing before you eat food and after you eat food. However, over here we have a very beautiful point. This Borei Nefashot that you're saying now, that's the pause you have to have before you actually get up right away. Meaning say like this. When you drink the 3 ounces, you can't get up right away. But if you say Baruch Atah Hashem, Elokeinu Melech Haolam, Borei Nefashot Rabot, V'chesronon, Al-Kom Ma'ash, V'rata, L'ha'chayu B'hem Nefesh Kochai, Baruchai Halomim. That time is enough, that's sufficient enough for you now to get up without a problem, and now you're not in that rule of that you are closer to death than to life. Now you might ask me a question, but what happens if I want to continue to drink? Or what happens if I want to continue to eat? Beseder. So whatever amount of time that it takes you to say Borei Nefashot, make a cheshbon, calculate it, 5 seconds. 10 seconds. So before you want to get up, wait 5 seconds or 10 seconds. And the same thing applies by Al-Hamiche if you're eating things that have to do with the 5 grains or Hamotzelech Min Ha'aretz for bread, for example. When you eat bread over there, the digestion system means that the pause of this is much greater than just by saying Borei Nefashot or Al-Hamiche. So if you are that person that says Birkat HaMazon 2 minutes, So that means that if you're eating bread now, you shouldn't get up right away and just go and start doing things. You would have to wait 2 minutes. Again, guys, all these things, Hashem, the Torah is so beautiful that it tells us exactly how to live life, how to take care of our health, and how we should be able to serve Hashem. Because if one of these things are not there, guys, if a person has a headache, or if he feels weak, or if he's tired, or things like that, you don't have that exact passion, you don't have that exact enthusiasm to be able to serve Hashem. You'll come to that day to shul, you want to download Shomer Esrei, you want to learn Torah, but your head is pounding. How are you going to be able to learn? You're not. So therefore, guys, there are reasons why Chazal teach us these things that we have to do. Why? In order for us to be able to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu with 100%. And anyway, guys, this is the halakha for today. Bezat Hashem, guys, this is the whole halakha for Simon Aleph, halakha Aleph. I try to go with you guys, try to do the halakha inside, in the Mishbura, and also in the Shulchan Aruch, and in the Ramam. Bezrat Hashem, tomorrow, what I would like to do is the Biur Halakha, where he speaks about the six constant mitzvot that each Jew must know. Because you have to understand, these six constant mitzvot that we'll speak about in the following Shiurim, that when a person does them, every second that you are thinking about them, you're making, there's no end how many mitzvot you can make. Thousands, millions of mitzvot you can make just by thinking about those six constant mitzvot. Bezat Hashem, we will take upon that in the following Shiurim. Guys, have a great and blessed day. May we always remember that Kadosh Baruch Hu is watching us, and may we be able to make our Father in Heaven happy. Baruch Adonai Olam. Amen. Amen.